What's going on, guys? Today, I wanted to kind of go over some of the general basics of shields and what shields do what, as in, like, some of the capacities and stuff. And I won't have all of the shields to show you, necessarily, because I don't keep all of them. But we can kind of give you a little overview on what to do, what you might like and everything in shields, because it's kind of, it goes by preference in this game. Whether you want a high capacity and a long recharge, or a low capacity and a quick recharge. And that's kind of how it works. It kind of does, kind of doesn't. So, really and truly, hands down, the favorite shield in the game is a respark. And that is because it has such a very short delay and a pretty quick recharge. And it kind of depends. Generally, if you have a respark, you'll see with the resistance, and it'll always say damage resistance, and you'll see the radiation sign there. That normally gives you a delay of about 2.4 seconds on a legendary shield. Now, remember that different colors will make different things. You don't have as much capacity. Your delay will be longer. Like, if this had been like a purple or maybe a like a blue, this would have been like 2.7 or 3 seconds instead of 2.4 seconds. Now, you see this one has no, you see it there, damage resistance. No damage resistance on this one. So this one gets a faster recharge. It has a 2.25 instead of a 2.4. It's to make up for you losing that resistance. Now, while this is a favorite one, it doesn't mean it's the best. Now, it is my favorite one, too. Obviously, I have more resparks than I do any other shields, but there, it just depends. Some people like shields that you can take a lot more rounds before your shield actually goes down. Like this Chimera Claw is actually just an ironclad in disguise. So this is going to have the same stats that any ironclad shield you see will have. And ironclads have a very high capacity and their recharge is very low. Now, the delay isn't horrible at 6 seconds. You're a full 10 seconds before your shield is 100%. That gives you 16 seconds that you have before your shield is back to full capacity again. Now, if you're running around with cloak, where if you cloak, it will bring your shield back up fast. It'll make your shield start recharging. Then maybe that's not such a bad choice for you. I don't run invisibility, so I run overcharge because in PvE, which is what I play, player versus environment. I do not play player versus player in this game. To me, I want something like a respark or a rebel or a hurricane, and really it would be more the hurricane than the rebel for me. Why? Once again, I do not like the 10% recharge per second. That is not good enough for me. Now, this does have a higher capacity, and not as high as the ironclad, but as you notice, it only has a 2.7 second delay. And this would go down further had this not been green. Had it been a higher rarity, it would have been a lower recharge. But I still do not like the 10% recharge per second. So that is my problem with the Rebel. Now, Rhino is another one. Now, I actually like the Rhino over the Ironclad. Now, this is just preference. Because, yes, I am stuck at 9.6 seconds before it will even begin to recharge. But I like the recharge per second. I do not like 10%. I want 40% or higher, personally. And that's why I kind of like the Rhino. And the Rhino, as you see, very high capacity again. Because you have such a long delay before your shield begins to recharge. And the Hurricane, to me, would probably be my second best shield. Second favorite shield. Now, if you look, you'll see 13.343. 13.346. These two are very close in their capacities. And the difference is, you can see the recharge per second and the recharge delay. Now, you do have to wait 6 full seconds before your shield begins recharging, but your shield is almost recharged instantly. 90%? That's almost instantly by the time that 6 seconds is up. 6 seconds, on that 7th second, boom, 90% of your shield is back. So that's one reason I do like Hurricanes as well. There's Tachyons too. they are kind of in the Rebel range, where they have a, you know, that kind of capacity, maybe a tiny bit higher, but they have like a 90 and 95% recharge, but their recharge delay is the same as the Rhino Blast Proof at 9.6 seconds. Now, there are different ways of taking care of things where I showed you how this has probably a higher capacity because, or I'm sorry, a higher recharge delay because it does not have a damage resistance like this shield does. Now, when you get up to the shields like this, they will not change the recharge, they will not change the delay, but they will give you a higher capacity to make up for it, like on a Rhino, and the same with a Ironclad. I think Tachyons might move up to like 95%, so it just depends on the shield. Whether or not what you're going to see, you might see faster time, faster recharge delay, you might see a faster recharge per second, or you might see a higher capacity. Those are the things you see whenever you lose a damage resistance on a shield. So that's just one of those things to kind of, you just kind of learn it as you play. You can kind of remember it. It's kind of important, but kind of not important. It just depends on what you want to use. I mean, honestly, the 2.25 is not that far of a cry from a 2.4. So it's just not that big of a deal. It just depends on what you're getting. Now, more capacity is always a big deal. You always want more capacity. So that's always kind of nice. But a resistance is nice. And that means if an enemy is shooting you with a radiation, then you have a higher damage resistance to radiation. If it has biological, you know, what we all call poop shoes, that means whenever you're being shot with something that would give you poop shoes, or when you're fighting hell bugs and they're spitting that at you, that you have a higher damage resistance to that particular element. So that's kind of what you have to look for in your damage resistances. Now, the thing to look at as well is the arcs. Arcs are more sought after shields. They're a little bit harder to get than all these other shields are. And actually, this is probably the most desired arc. Not by everybody, but by most people. It's a Respark Regenerator 5 arc. I put up a video of me getting it and everything. Took me a very long time to get my hands on one as well. But I think, personally, from my point of view, a regenerating arc is, or a regenerator shield, period, is the way to go. I like the HP regeneration. When you just look at your health just crawling back up, you put on even a 50% or like this one, it makes a huge difference in how fast your health comes back. I love health regeneration over all these others, like a charger where it's 8% less damage while your shield is recharging, 15% reload when your shield is down on a reloader shield. Now, that's the other thing to look for, too, is when you get a shield that does something nifty like that, you really have to pay attention as to what it does. Like, this is straightforward. 30% less damage from your explosives. Well, that's easy to figure out, and it's actually a really good shield, which is why I've kept it. But when you get something like this, 15% reload when your shield is down is really good, but you really want it on a shield that has a longer delay. You really want it on your Rhino Blast Proof, on your Ironclad, on your Tachyon. That's where you really want to see something with the windshield is down, because your shield is going to come up fairly quickly on a respark. And even on this charger, 8% less damage while your shield is recharging. Well, the shield recharge, you see the 40%, that means in 3 seconds your shield is fully back. So for 3 seconds you're taking 8% less damage. Well, that means you take a bullet and your shield has stopped recharging. So it's one bullet. So you have to read kind of the fine print. And even this Rebel Reloader, 5% reload when the shield is down on this one too. Well, once again, the recharge delay is so... this one isn't a bad. The Rebel is a good one to have it on, because you have the 10%. So it's 10 seconds before your shield is going to fully recharge. So a Rebel is a good place to have something that says when your shield is down. So that's not so bad. Because, I mean, even if you're getting shot and they're keeping your shield out, once again, I guess that helps. But you really want a longer capacity. So you have to look at that. Or something that gives you fire, like I think it's fire rate while your shield is recharging. Something like that. You, whenever it says what shield is recharging, you want it to have, you want a 10% is what you want. You want to see the 10% recharge per second. That's always better. So you kind of have to kind of look at everything that's going on with your shield and kind of say, okay, how this says it does it while my shield is recharging. Is it 10%? Is it 40%? Is it 90%? Because if it's 90%, that's, you know, pretty darn fast. So that's not going to give you that perk for very long. So, and that's one of the reasons why I like the regenerators. When your health is 100% full, you are always regenerating health. So that's why I like them. They just work. It isn't a matter of shield up, shield down, shield recharging. They just work. When your shield is fully recharged, they just work. And I'm trying to talk and read the screen at the same time. So that's kind of my knowledge of shields to an extent and what I can kind of even show you for what I have. I don't have everything, but you just kind of look at them and read them and just remember what they say. When it says you get a perk when your shield is down, then that means as soon as your shield starts recharging, you no longer receive that. If it says while your shield is recharging, if your shield is either fully up or fully down, you are not getting that. And so I think there might be one or something that says when your shield is fully charged, but I could be thinking of a perk and just confusing myself too. So without being able to see it, I don't know. But that's my little tidbits on shields. Remember that even though this is a great shield, a shield with the damage resistance is great. And really and truly, radiation and bio are really, really good to have. Especially bio, because you get shot with biological weapons a lot by the NPCs in this game. So bio is a really good one to have. Now do remember that the rarity does affect the armor plates that you have. Now, if it's white, green, or blue, you're going to have one armor plate. If it's purple, you're going to have two armor plates. If it's orange or legendary, you are going to have three armor plates. And that is important because the armor plates reduce the amount of damage you take. So if you have three armor plates, you take 30% less damage while you have three. So having a legendary shield is kind of an important thing. So that you can have all that damage reduction. So that is about what I have on shields. So I will catch you guys later.